Okay, this is kind of an awkward opening hand. I think we're going to keep, but we have all cards that care about artifacts and no artifacts, though our deck is relatively full of those, so I think we will keep and hope for the best. Alright. Don't really know what's going on with Magic Online. It's like not showing what's going on over here, so I'm going to have to restart. Alright, when I restarted Modo, for some reason there was the pack opening sound, which is interesting. And looks like despite being on the far left instead of the far right, we drew a Smuggler's Copter, which is pretty perfect, so go us. We did it. We're playing against, I assume, just a black-white deck. Our deck does have both these cards, or... Actually, it has previously had Shambling Vent. It does not currently, so I misspoke. But it's probably some sort of black-white control deck. Or mid-range slash control deck. I guess maybe they think about killing this in response, though me then crewing and like, in response to them killing my guy doesn't really do anything, so. But if they're gonna kill my guy next turn, no matter what, might as well. I don't know. Could very easily have Grasp of Darkness there. The other two mana removal spell of choice could be, drawing a blank, but the one that exiles. Alright, well. They had Deadweight, which I assume they drew since they could have cast it last turn. Well, a little awkward that we cannot cast all of these spells this turn, though maybe we can if we get lucky on our looting. Well, it's the only red one we have, so I guess this is the most likely to be cast, so might as well use that. And they could have just been saving their removal spell to kill my Smuggler's Copter. But, oh well. You got me. I do believe that is what they did. So I just play Toolcraft Exemplar. You know, if I had a Selfless Spirit there, that's kind of the ideal spot for it. Getting to crew a Selfless Spirit protects your copter very well, but... Alright, well, luckily we have a very clean answer to this Gideon. Unluckily we can't... Oh, well, I thought we did. We don't have an artifact anymore, so. We do not have a clean answer to the stupid Gideon. We will next turn, hopefully. And drew the Selfless Spirit a turn too late. So, I don't think we want to trade off our Exemplar. We can just attack the Gideon here. Pretty likely to kill it next turn. Okay. Could just incendiary flow the Gideon. That does let us also play Selfless Spirit. Doesn't sound that bad. And we like to save the Unlicensed Disintegration for later. So, yeah, let's just do that. I would like to redirect it. Guess we'll attack. I don't know if it's better to leave back for more pilgrims or more Selfless Spirit shenanigans. Though we can block Knight on Inventor's Apprentice and double block another Knight and chump block Shambling Vent or some combination of those doesn't seem too bad. Scares me another Gideon. I mean, a live fast is, you know, not threatening their life total that much. Still pretty good right now, but I wonder if they have any way to use the energy, or if this is just purely a card draw spell that is kind of marginal. Alright, Liliana is super annoying. Jeez. Okay. Well, luckily, the Unlicensed Integration can kill her, but still super annoying. So I'm going to attack with Inventor's Apprentice 2, hoping that they double block. I think that makes sense. I'm sort of hoping at some point this Toolcraft Exemplar will get first strike, but maybe I'm hoping for a little too much. Yeah, I guess this does sort of lock me into like playing the Unlicensed Integration, so maybe I should have attacked with the Exemplar also. This deck probably has like Avacyn and stuff. So really, do I care that much if my Pilgrim's Eye dies? Probably not. So I'm basically just letting them kill my Pilgrim's Eye, but like waiting for a juicier target for Unlicensed Integration. Yeah, sure, I guess. Could be very wrong. What I really need is a Scrap Heap Scrounger right now. Well, Blighted Fen, I have enough kind of crappy guys that shouldn't be too bad for me. Alright. Seems pretty hard for Avacyn not to be super bad for me. So maybe I just like do this in their upkeep in case, like, if they don't have Avacyn, then whatever. Yeah. I'm gonna do it then. And hope they just cast Avacyn right now, because attacking Avacyn there is just like too bad. I don't think I can do that. Alright, well, they just have Avacyn. I now feel very smart for waiting. Alright. Though, I just realized I sacrificed my clue, so now I don't really feel smart anymore. Now I feel like an idiot, because I thought I was going to get to kill this Liliana, and I didn't. So, that was a dramatic reversal from I feel smart to I feel very stupid. So, unlike in the humans deck, where it's just like always good to sacrifice Jam Inspector token, here it just turns off your guys sometimes. Alright, well, this is, I think, pretty much gone to the realm of unwinnable game. So, probably going to be conceding pretty soon here. I don't think it's going to do it. Leon just kills that token, so we'll concede this game. Not really sure I'm supposed to sideboard against this deck. I think there's a version of this deck with smaller creatures. Like, not super small, but like with... I don't think I saw a copter or anything. But if they have copter, they gotta have things to crew it. Like Alien, Thalia and stuff. If they really are just removal and big things, then Incendiary Flow is pretty terrible. Selfless Spirit feels pretty terrible against Liliana. Not even really sure about Exemplar, but it might be good enough. Transgress sounds good. Gideon doesn't really sound all that great, but I guess that's probably going to be good enough. This does kill Avacyn, which is a good thing, but I don't know if it's a good enough thing. And this might be good at threatening Planeswalkers. I feel like I don't have a great sideboard for a deck that potentially has very few creatures and also has a Leonidas to negate a lot of my guys. I suppose it's okay if they kill Pilgrim's Eye. It seems pretty bad if they kill Selfless Spirit. I would like to play first. No, I think we got a mulligan this one. Well, it's just the same hand, minus one land, but I guess that's, like, good that I get the scry now. I would probably shuffle away a land to scry in that previous hand. I think we keep... I just hope we hit a guy that makes the exemplar a 3-2. Alright, I suppose I'll keep... God, no, I don't want that. Alright. Alright, good start, good start. Alright. Just can't ever win, I think is where we're at. I can unlicense disintegration something, so it doesn't deal 3 damage, but I can cast the card. So we got that going for us. Wow. Okay. Like maybe if I draw Gideon this turn, I can kind of be in the game. Seems incredibly difficult for me to win this game. Well, Inventor's Apprentice, I would not call a good start to that. Yeah, the deck is crapping out on me, unfortunately. It's probably not the most exciting thing to watch, I apologize. If we were just doing like a testing game or something, I would just be like, let's just reset this and do another one. So many Planeswalkers. Maybe this deck is great. I don't know. Seems like it has close to enough tools just by itself in only 2 colors. Well, this is a good draw. I was gonna say I could attack with my guy, but I can't actually, because it's just gonna have one power, I think. It was almost a good draw. Oh, 0 power. Okay, good. Like an unlicensed. And kill a token and not kill a planeswalker. Yeah, I thought that was better when I could, like, kill the token and then this has 2 power and... It seemed like there's more I could do, but there is not. I think I just have to hope I draw another artifact. Given that I don't have the exile all the cards with the same name card, which I'm drawing a blank on, I don't really know that I'm beating all these Knight Ally tokens at this point. Alright. I could continue to play and have... Watch me slowly lose, but I think we're pretty clearly losing this game given the amount of lands we've drawn. So, sorry, but I think that is all for this match. Okay, well, wow, thanks for letting me know that you had me covered. I don't know what the point of showing me that was. Anyway, so I'm not sure about Pilgrim's Eye versus Caravan, aside from that you definitely want one of that type of card. Pilgrim's Eye wasn't as embarrassing as I thought it would be. It did hold off the 2 of the 3-1 guy in one of the matches earlier. And I guess it, you know, I didn't need that much fuel, but it is fuel for Scrap Heap Scrounger. There could be some games where you do need it. So it's not an embarrassing card. It might not be better than Caravan, but I did need the mana a few times. Like, so I think one of those three drop guys should be in the deck. Overall, the deck felt pretty good. I mean, I think this black-white deck is just, like, a really horrible matchup. I mean, it's just, like, all removal and planeswalkers. I don't think that's a deck that this deck is likely to beat. Especially given that our most powerful one-drop just dies to Liliana just incidentally. But it does seem like a good choice overall. I think it's good against the blue control decks. So I'm probably going to play something close to this in the Grand Prix this weekend. So yeah, I guess check out that coverage. I guess it'll be in the past by the time this posts. But hopefully there's good news for me by the time you see this. So all right, thanks for watching, guys.